Hi guys, I'm Shmi and good evening to you from Dubai, where I'm about to show you around a rather cool little private collection, not only just because the cars are awesome, but also the garage itself is pretty special. So this is the collection of Instagrammer Don Casanova 75. The link is down below, and you might have seen some of his cars before, including a chrome blue Veyron. If you haven't, you're about to, but check out how cool this looks with the cars on display in this garage. So I'm going to show you around the cars. We're going to hear some of them, take a look at the modifications and customization, because this is just awesome. The way they are displayed down here is extraordinary. I'm actually completely mesmerized by how cool it looks and how the sort of lighting in here works. I mean, as I said, as much interested in that, I think, as how the cars are themselves. But I mean, let's start off. We've got the Rolls Royce Wraith luxury coupe, dual tone silver grey paintwork there. Then we've got the Mansory Carbonado Aventador, so tuned up versus the standard Aventador, twin turbo, 1600 horsepower, but carbon fiber everywhere. Replacement body panels, the carbon fiber wing, the roof and rear deck that you can see here, all the way through the bonnet, the louvres added here too, the lower sections, Mansory badge on front and at the side, and of course the Reventon style wheels, which are all very cool. Now, just to sort of rewind a sec, remember, we are in Dubai, land of, well, pretty much everyone and his mother having an Aventador SV. So out here, it's cooler to have something that's a little bit more exclusive, that stands out a bit more. And it seems strange saying that against an SV, but the Carbonado is strictly limited, and we're about to hear it. Let's move on from the Mansory Aventador to the Bugatti. The first of three cars in here, in the chrome blue. We'll move on to the other two in a second. But this is an original 16.4 Veyron coupe, 1,001 horsepower. And you can see it here in the handling mode, which we've just done to raise the wing. Let me roll that. Think it's so cool seeing that wing rising up out of the back, and you can see the exhaust box inside as well. But this color, with the lighting in here and the way the lines reflect off the curves of the car, just looks awesome. I mean, the Veyron is always cool, but in the chrome blue with the mirror chrome sort of front and wing sections, just awesome. So nice. The lighting is just nuts. I love it so much. And of course, the sort of tinted windows looking pretty cool as well. The beast that is the W16 in the Bugatti Veyron. So let's move on from the Veyron to the Flying Spur and the drop head. Both sort of done to match, although the silver on here is of course from the factory, the brushed aluminium that you can get from Rolls-Royce, with the Spirit of Ecstasy sitting proud at the front. Next to that, the Bentley Flying Spur with the silver wrap to give it the same sort of two-tone style finish over the top and around the side, but with the gloss black roof. I think these are all so cool. Imagine driving on the road together with all three of those matching. Just awesome. Now this is an interesting pairing. Ferrari 488 GTB and the McLaren 650S Spider. Pretty similar, 670 horsepower twin turbo V8, 650 horsepower twin turbo V8, slightly lighter because carbon tub. But these cars are both customized quite heavily. You can see the sort of carbon fiber vinyl design on here to give kind of an aggression to the front, around the sides, the red pinstriping on the wheels, more carbon over the roof. It's pretty good actually, it looks very sort of real, if that's the term, and around the rear too. And remember, like I said before, this is about making a car that sort of stands out. Red fins down the bottom as well, I've just noticed, and look a bit different. Exactly as per the McLaren, which is in a custom bespoke paint, painted, not wrapped. But again, some individual kind of designs, like the diffuser around the back, the wheels, all done to be unique. And then those are quite like the sort of P1 style at the front. They give that kind of effect. And the pinstriping around the bottom as well. Then we've got the Phantom and the Mansory Ghost. Phantom, luxury, cruiser, chauffeur car. And the Ghost, well, Mansory, livens it up again, makes it a little bit more distinct, the two-tone, the sort of bronze, light brown, and the white. And this, for a car like this, sounds pretty good. God, that's unusual for a Rolls Royce. Sort of backfire pops. Surprising, right? You don't expect that to come out of a Rolls Royce. I filmed once with a Rolls Royce that had a sort of modified exhaust system. It was a Wraith at Haman. And hearing that was pretty surprising, but that's almost kind of Mercedes-like in a way. So I mean, like I said, I think the coolest thing for me in here, well, besides the cars, is how awesome this is as a garage. You know, you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 cars on display, but surrounded by the lighting, just bouncing off the wraps and designs and paintwork, looking so, so good with the glossy floor and the mirrored walls. Beautiful, beautiful place to display cars. And I'm just gonna come through here as well. How's this for a bar area where you can sit and enjoy looking out at that? This is like my dream. Just a cool, cool garage and way of displaying your cars. Well, being able to see 7 from here, tucked into the lighting. It very, 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 very much makes sense when you think about where we are. And of course, the house above is presumably rather spectacular as well, but it's awesome of Don to let me come and have a look. I mean, I've seen many, many pictures of this car on the internet, so it's cool to see it in person. The Veyron. But yeah. Not bad, hey? Not bad at all. Love looking around this kind of place. And I've been lucky enough to drive, of course, many of these cars before now. The Bugatti. I don't know if I've ever actually driven a standard Veyron. I've driven the Vitesse, the WRC, at the Nürburgring N24, which was awesome. Obviously, Aventador a couple of times. In fact, I shot a video with a Mansory Aventador a long, long time ago. Not many of you will have been around, I think, back in those days. I've driven the Flying Spur, went on a tour with Bentley, 488 very briefly with Josh Cartu, but I'm hopefully going to shoot something with Ferrari soon, driving a car. 650S, of course, well, I had mine for a while, and then a few more Rolls Royces. Now, you might be wondering why so many Rolls Royces. Well, choice, different cars for different purposes. They're obviously quite a desirable car out here for luxury transport, so they make sense. Now, the owner also has a Koenigsegg Agera, but unfortunately that car is not here at the moment, so I can't show you, but hopefully I'll be able to see it at some point. How cool is this, just as a garage? Just think about having cars. It's not just about the cars, it's about where you store them, how you display them, and just, I mean, if this was mine, I'd be really, really happy. It's such a nice place to see the cars on display. Awesome, right. I think I've rambled enough. This is awesome, lovely little collection. Hope you enjoyed the video and seeing Don Castanova's little garage of cars here in Dubai. So thank you very much for watching, guys. That's it for now. I'll catch up with you again very soon. Cheers.